All right, so I got a couple of goodies that came in. And I got some more Hot Racing diff cups, but this is for the 5T. All right, here's part number. Now, thing I don't like about these, I do not know why. I don't see any bleeder holes here. There's no venting holes on these. MTXL, DVXL, you have them. I don't know. I may drill out a hole and tap it and put a little grub screw. Or I may just fill the diff cup less, right up to where it's supposed to be. I usually like to top them off. I like to fill them bitches up, right? And then I bleed them through the hole. You know, but anyway, whatever. So worst comes to worst, either I'll drill a hole, tap it, and freaking put a grub screw. Very easy to do. Or I'll put a little bit of diff oil where it's supposed to be at. And let me see if I have a hot... Here's a Hot Racing diff cup for the DBXL. And you see you got a diff, you got a hole there. That hole is to bleed the diff cup and also to run the pin. Right, the pin that that holds your gear, your beveled gear inside. Alright. So on the diff cup of the 5T it's different. So it's more of a performance diff cup for racing with the heavy duty. It's similar to the LST2 and the eight platform. You know, the race truggies and buggies, where the diffs are slightly different. So the DBXL, you have your pins, right? You just have the pins that run through that hold your bevel gear, your spider gears. On the 5T, more of a performance, more of a racing, you have that, the heavy duty, the HD style, right? It has like a square flange, a square piece of metal there, which makes things stiffer. These are strong, man. There's no way you're gonna be bending these or I don't know, I just went with the aluminum ones just in case, but these are way stronger than stock-wise. Way stronger than the DBXL, all right, and MTXL, way stronger, but, and there's a size difference, there's a little bit of a size difference as well, all right. I'm not going to get into the diffs yet, we will do this another time. I just want to start off with the chassis. Oh, and I got some extra boots here. I got plenty of these shits now. I got low C ones. Alright, rubber's slightly better. And you have these here from Speed, Top Speed RC. They're really cheap. I picked them up. If they rip, I'll redo them again. Otherwise, I'll just put some low C ones and it'll last another 6 years. Who knows? Because those are originals. This is original. Alright, it's 7 years old. Alright, but it's been ripped for probably a year. That's it. And so anyway, check this out. Check out my chassis. Remember my chassis? This is what I've been doing. I want to heat. I want to heat it up now. This is how I cleaned up my chassis. I'm gonna heat it up and keep pressing, rubbing, heat up, rubbing. I want to make sure that shit is on there good. Everything is folded and bent. Alright. Make sure everything's in the groove. And then we will get to the bottom one. Alright. So yeah. That's my 7-year-old chassis. I'm going to be applying this. Too bad. I don't know if I should apply this now or after everything is built. You know, but because I would like to cover all the holes. that's how I had it last time. You know, but then if I have to remove a motor or or whatever, then I'd have to cut out. So maybe I'll just put it how it's supposed to go on. But some people do put the sticker over the screws. I mean, completely make it like one piece, you know, but I probably won't be doing that. So anyway, stay tuned. It's all cleaned up. I'm gonna pass some more alcohol pads on it. And that's it. I'm just gonna heat it up, press it on. I believe I told you guys the name of this, the last video. Alright, let me say it again. It's from RC Decals. Alright. So. Alright, now what you're supposed to do is start from the middle. Align it. Alright, this one was a bitch a little bit. It's not perfect. The sticker kit is not perfect, but this is the best I could do. Right? So that's a little off, but this is the best I could do. If I go back any further, then it's going to be too short up here. So, right? Grab a wheel. Massage the bitch in with this. Alright. Once the middle is flattened out and stuck, start doing the sides, start curling. So bending the sides. All right, I'm gonna heat the bitch up. Check it out. And then it'll bend on its own. Look at that. Look at that beautiful chassis, huh? Zah! Look at that son of a... That's what I'm talking about. I'm gonna heat this all up. Heat it up, heat it up. Put pressure, rubber down, all right? You guys got this. All right, all done. With the chassis, that is. Yeah, so now I would hate to scratch this up, even though it's a damn sticker. I may have to stock up on these stickers. at least we won't have to worry about the inner side. Yeah, man, it's gonna look nice. It's gonna be badass with all that fucking chrome and shit. Give me a nice. Look at that shit looks fast already. That shit looks wavy as it. Look at that. Oh man, now what? Now I want to put a cloth on my damn stand. I'm afraid to put this on there. I don't want to scratch it. That's fucked up, right? Shit. What are you gonna do? Alright. Well, look what we got here. More goodies. More goodies that came in here. This. My buddy was here from Amsoil. My sponsor. He gave me some stickers. Let's open these goodies up. I still have more. I got more on the way here. I got some also being sent to my local hobby store is getting me as well. Let's start over here. Alright, so let's open these goodies up. Let's see what we got. Cool. Alright. Cool. I don't know if I'm doing a mistake removing my Fast Eddie, but I'm gonna go with these, so hopefully the adjustments on this is not bad. I'm probably gonna chrome these. I'm gonna get them chromed. Or maybe I'll polish them up. Nah, I'll chrome them. Alright, it's gonna be another batch. Probably another batch of chroming. This right here is gonna be more parts to chrome. Still gotta get these done. I may get these. I'm thinking about chroming this and this. Alright, chroming my Losi caps. These are real Losi shocks. These are freaking awesome shocks. Right. If I had a DBXL today, I would freaking upgrade to the Losi 5T shocks. That's what I would do. First thing I would do to a DBXL. But I still have to do this, take this apart. But I don't know. I may even do this, but you know, have one of these blocks chromed would be badass. Be nice. This is a very nice block. Very strong. Works well. Okay, let's take this bitch apart. Let's see what's in here. Let's see what we got here. Bag number one. Bartolone Racing replacement silicone coupler. Alright, always good to have these shits in stock. I have a couple of Bartolone pipes, my MTXL, my 5T. I have a few friends that have Bartolone pipes, and it's always good to have spares, if not for me, for my buddies as well. Alright, this is good to have spares as well. I've never had a problem with my 6-year-old Turtle Racing pull start, but is like a rebuild kit parts. All right, it's a dog cage kit part number. It's a version 2. Shit, I may have the version 1. I can always upgrade to this, I guess, hopefully, unless the version 1 is the upgraded part. I know a few people with problems with the version 2s. I don't have a problem with version 1, so. Anyway, this is something you guys should have. Every one of my buddies, every one of my gas brothers, all right? Not Nitro brothers, because Nitro brothers don't need this shit. But the gas guys, get yourself one of these bitches right here. Zenoa Flywheel Air Gap Gauge Tool. It's like I said before many times, it's time to work like gentlemen, guys. Alright? Yeah, you can use your business card and all that bullshit. Yeah, I had a few business cards here that I would use. This is a tool. Alright, this is the accurate tool gauge. Alright? This is not a shim. This is it's a gauge. Alright? The correct gauge, the proper tool for your flywheel and coil, to adjust your coil, all right? There's a lot of guys out there that think they have their shit all good and dandy. Meanwhile, that shit don't start for shit. And then they'd be fucking up pull starts and all that shit. Meanwhile, something so simple, they didn't have the correct gap or other issues. Like I've seen many times, it even happened to me many times. Cracked intake manifolds, you know, all that shit. So if you have one of these, you won't have that problem. So that's one problem out of the way. Next problem, fuel with ethanol. Fuel with ethanol dries up your fuel lines, dries this shit up. All right, this grommet. And if you don't have a high flow fuel line kit like this, what happens is this starts to squeeze, squeezes your fuel lines, tightens them up. And you people have issues running their shit. Meanwhile, they think, oh, they're leaning out their motor. So they start richening their adjustments. They start fucking with the carburetor. Meanwhile, it has nothing to do with your carburetor or adjustments. It's because your damn fuel lines are getting squished. They're getting freaking, your fuel lines are on a, is in a headlock by this shit. Alright, you know what I'm saying? So, to prevent that, if you guys are still going to be running pump gas with ethanol in it, man, I hope you're using Startron with it, and I hope you're using a good oil, good quality oil. If not, get yourself one of these high flow bitches right here. At least when this shrinks, it won't squeeze. Oh, look at this shit. Oriole sees a dog on TV, he wants to. Anyway, sit down. Sit your ass down. So anyway, you get one of these high flow kits, they're great. All right. What else? So that'll prevent the problem, believe it or not. All right, there's little things you guys could do to prevent problems. The shim is the correct one is great. Something you guys could always have in your toolbox. You know, you slap this bitch on your flywheel, get to the magnetic part. Drop your coil, get your coil loose, let the bitch drop. All right, tighten up your coil to the correct gauge right here. All right, sometimes with business cards it could get squished, or if you reuse the business card more than once, it could not give you an accurate gauge, an accurate adjustment on your coil. All right, anyway, I got one of these. It's a pretty cool, pretty nice fuel filter. All right, where was I, man? I keep getting freaking interrupted. I keep getting phone calls during this fucking video I'm doing right now, and I keep getting interrupted from people upstairs. Sorry. All right, where the hell was I? All right, fuel filter. This is called a winged, what the hell is it called? A winged clunk fuel filter. There's a part number. Right. I hope. Did I get your part numbers on this shit? Let's see. Zenoa flywheel air gap gauge tool, DR330 DDM. RB Innovations. One more time. Once again. Part number. All right. IB 2005. Okay. Oh, and don't forget. You're gonna have to get the gasket. Get a new gasket before you guys put this on. Yes, it comes with a nice gasket. This plastics are the best. All right, but that's for your carburetor. For this side that goes on the motor, get yourself, do not reuse the gasket on your motor. Get a new one. All right, they should be giving you not one, but two gaskets, and they don't. All right, maybe they want you to reuse the same fucking gasket on the motor. Do not do that. Don't take any chances. This shit is on for good for a long time, bro. You're not messing this shit up. It's impossible. So get a new gasket. These are awesome. Even if your shit is like running low, or if it's on an angle, you know, and you have fuel on one end or whatever, this is awesome. It grabs from all over the place. It should be a very cool. What a great idea from Walbro to have this, right? This ain't no aftermarket shit or nothing. It's a Walbro carburetor part. Very nice. All right. This is, now, what else? Let's put this on here. Here. Yeah. That's two. What else? What else we got here? Alright, I picked up one of these DDM socket holder adapters with the quarter inch X drivers. Alright. Just in case if I get a different drill, if I use a different drill, like my Milwaukee, instead of using the impact, I can use my Milwaukee with a clutch setting on it, and I can just keep this bit, this adapter on it at all times. Then it'll be nice and easy for click, click, click. You know what I'm saying? It'll be nice and easy to lock up my hex drivers. These are great tools from DDM that you can get. Everybody should have this. Nitro and gas, guys. All right, look at these. These are nice fucking tools, great tools. And you can't beat the price, not bad at all. And so I can snap them in here, snap them off. Pretty cool adapter. You can lock them in. All right. Night part number. I believe it's the CA198. All right, socket holder adapter. Okay. Speak tools. Since I'm here with this shit, CA195. All right, I've had these for a long time. I actually have more in here. I don't know how much they cost now. I bought this at my local hobby store. Oh man, probably 4 or 5 years ago? 6 years ago, maybe? Maybe, I don't know. But anyway. Oh man, nice. Look at this sexy piece right here. Wow. Oh man. Look at this sexy piece. I am not gonna open this up just yet, but let me tell you something. Look at this, man. Look at this beautiful piece, man. I cannot wait to open this sucker up. This is a work of art right here. This is from Dark Soul Racing. Okay, it's a lightened flywheel. A true lightened flywheel. Not a knockoff, not a Chinese lightened flywheel. This is a real lightened flywheel, like with air gaps in the bitch. Like real light, not none of this, just chopped up fins, all right? You pay a little bit more, but I'm telling you, this is the best shit. But this isn't for everybody, all right? Some of you guys that run your shit hot all the time, not a good idea to have this. There's not enough air, okay? So you run the risk of overheating your motor. But man, I can tune my shit. I know where I have my shit, and I'll be fine with this. I won't use this on a reed case. I won't use this on something heavily modified. But listen, I got a friend, my buddy Chris, Everyday RC, man. He has this sucker on his big bore kit that he did on a 2060C. All right, he did a big bore kit on his original stock Losi motor. All right, he did a big bore on that sucker, and he ran a lightened flywheel for years, and he has no issues. And listen, it's not just because of his videos. I've seen his 5T in person many times, not once, not twice, but many times. That sucker can fly. He runs that shit all day. Like at a couple of bash events I've been to, I've seen that car in action. All right, the one from 2 years ago, that fucking 5T of his just kept, he out jumped everybody. He was showing off. That car was just jumping up. Watch his video. Try to go to his channel, Everyday RC, and look up like 2 years ago bash event. All right, it was like three parts. All right, it was one that was a giveaway, and there was just look it up. I don't know the name of it offhand. You go there and you'll see. You will see Fit Scale Fun. Or there was like part one, part two, and three. I think part two was the Fit Scale RC's bashing video that he did of that day. And you'll see his 5T non-stop jump after jump after jump. And it did not overheat once. There was people there with 68cc motors, big ass shit. Those suckers overheated. Those guys barely ran their cars, all right, with those whacked out motors, you know. But anyway, I'm gonna be trying this out on a project I have coming up. Okay, I'm gonna be using that on one of my motors. And let me give you a part number of this in case you guys want. Lightened flywheel part number DSR0120. Okay, made in USA. Nice shit. I'm telling you, if I remove this out of the bag, it's a nice piece. They did a nice job. All right, we got some heavy duty skid plates from Jofer USA. All right, for the 5T. All right, this black is gonna get scraped up, but whatever. I got a nice deal on it. It was on sale. You guys can look on DDM's website. They have a sale. Sometimes they have sale of the day, sale of the week. So, you know, always check. You can take advantage of good prices. And anyway, heavy duty skid plate. All right, supposedly there's like two of them. This is a heavy duty version of theirs. LHD-45BK. Okay, another one made in the USA. All right. No. So far, this is a great table right here. Everything here right now, made in the USA. I mean, this is how you do it. You know. Oh, shit. I see another. All right. Total Racing V2 Polestar cog kit. Part number 1391. All right. It's good to have spares and shit. You know, I should have got two of these, you know, just to have, because I'm planning on possibly getting, I don't really have issues with pull starts. I have stock shits. I really don't care about pull starts. That's the last thing on my mind. And I just don't think or worry about a pull start. I never have problems with pull starts. What else we got here? Fast Eddie bearings, sealed bearing kit, part number. This is for the Losi 5T. Or for your guys with the King Motors or whatever. I'm not familiar with their names that much. I think it's Roven LT or Roven. They have a Roven LT 305 and 320, I believe. I could be wrong. And the part number is 1306 TFE SM150. Damn. That can't be the part number. This is the part number. DDM part number, SM150. All right, from Fast Eddie, great bearings. They're not that expensive. Pretty good price and good quality. All right. Now, I mean, there's others. There's like ceramic shit that's like stupid price, but you can't go wrong with these. They're great. Another candy. What else we got? Oh, shit. This is for my future project, man. I wish I could be done with my 5T so I could start on that freaking thing. this is, I don't even want to give you guys this part number. You guys, there's no need for you guys to have this. This is a 9500 high RPM clutch spring, okay? Don't run these guys. Everybody should be running 8000 RPM clutch springs. Don't do that 6000 shit. It'll be frustrating, they're tiring. Back in the day, most people ran these 6,000 springs. They hated them. It felt like the engine was tired or getting tired. And then we lost a lot of people to the E-words. And then they had no idea it was because of their stupid clutch spring and clutches. All right. So 8,000 is great. You have a decent motor that runs decent. 8,000 clutch spring is perfect for you guys. All right, for everything. All right, but a 9500 is kind of crazy. The reason why I bought a DDM 9500 is because they are very accurate. All right, they're very accurate. They've been tested through many people. I even have a friend that actually tested this. All right, my buddy Rich Gordon. All right, really a pro with fit scales from Vermont. He has no YouTube channel. I wish he did, but even he has tested this shit with an RPM gauge, special RPM gauge he has, and it engaged at exactly at 9,500 RPMs. He said to not get the knockoff versions I forget what names he said. There's knockoff versions of this. Supposedly, if you see a 10,000 RPM spring, that it's fake. There is no 10,000 RPM spring. The ones that say 10,000 RPM spring were actually 93 and 9,200. And some of them were found to be 9,000. All right, so they're a bunch of bullshit. But supposedly these DDMs are accurate as fuck. So, just in case you want to experiment, or if you have a lighter car, you know, I wouldn't put one of these suckers on MTXL. Hell no, or anything. But I have something planned for this. All right, this is for my next project that I'm going to be doing. I'll explain everything when we get to it, when it's time for it. Anyway, G2220A is the part number for the 9500 spring. And what else? I think that's it, man. Another sticker. That's it for today. I have more shit coming on Wednesday. All right, but for now, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. All right, so anyway, now I'm just waiting, man. This is gonna take longer than I expected. I'm waiting on my buddy with the chroming. Who knows what the hell happened. I'm just gonna have to wait. I can't do nothing without those parts. All right, that's gonna be a pain in the ass.